God wants to take his church back to him. So now the question is, are we willing to give his church back to him? Or are we going to be the king in the church? Are we going to say, no, Lord, this is mine? This is where the test will begin. Who is the real Lord of the church? Are we willing to lay down the crown at the feet of the Lord Jesus and say, Lord, you are the shepherd. You are the bishop of our souls. So you please sit on the throne. Are we willing to do that? Or are we said, no, I will not give up my crown. This is mine. This is my turf. Then you are a mafia don, you know. Some behave like that, you know. This is my turf. How dare you come into my city without my permission? Very sad. Very sad. No sheep belongs to any pastor. Every pastor, we are just custodian. I did not die for anybody. Neither have I sweated blood for anybody. I have never been beaten or whipped with 40 stripes for anybody. There is only one person who has done all that for you. And he's the only one who can own you. No apostle, no prophet, no evangelist, no pastor, no teacher can ever claim that you are their property. Just because your name is in the membership roll, it doesn't mean the pastor or the minister has a copyright, intellectual property right over you. If anybody behaves like that, then they have the Nebuchadnezzar spirit. My Babylon. Then your church is not the church of God, you know. It's the church of Babylon. It's the kingdom of Babylon that rules in your midst. It's the Nebuchadnezzar spirit that rules there. Not the spirit of Christ. The spirit of Christ, see, so beautifully illustrated in Revelation chapter 5. When the 24 elders took their crowns from their heads and laid down at the feet of the Lord Jesus, and they fell prostrate before him and worshipped him. The crown on their head was given to them by the Lord himself, but they did not claim it to be their right. They willfully laid down at his feet. Even the Lord himself, when he was on this earth, Philippians chapter 2, verses 6 to 8 tells us, though he was God, he did not consider it robbery to be equal with God. He did not consider it to be a great something to be addressed as the Son of God. He just threw away that title. See, there are many proofs in the Bible for that, you know. Many times the many demons will say, oh, you Son of God. He says, shut up. Shut your mouth out. Don't say it. You remember that? He said that many times. He did not count it robbery to be equal with God. He never cared for that title. He never cared. Whether you call me the Son of God or you don't call me the Son of God, it doesn't bother me. I have come for one purpose. That is to die on the cross. That was his purpose. And to live the life that Adam was to have supposedly lived. A life of absolute obedience to God.